Now, so whatever you have downloaded by using that npm install commands, everything, the references are mentioned in this particular file. What is the main file? What is the index file? If you wanted to change the structure, means not the structure, then we were talking about, no, my application will launch with this particular file. I can specify the file name. I have created a lot of TS file. I wanted to, this particular file should be the entry point for my application. I can give that name. Every configuration is written here only. Another is the browser list. How many browsers this application is going to support? Greater than last two versions of Firefox? Not IE9. Just understand, it is not going to support IE9 till 11. For IE9 till 11 support, remove the word called not. If I wanted to support this application with IE9, I have to remove this one. Simple, straightforward. Automatically, it will work on Internet Explorer also. Karma Jasmine is nothing but mainly for the testing purpose. We have to use it for writing the unit test cases. We'll talk about package.json. Package.json, when you have installed the NPM, whatever the libraries got downloaded in your machine, in your application, what was the versions, you will see it here only. This particular file, package.json. Just leave this one. It's not required for us for now. We'll see these things later stage. Now, the most important part which we are going to discuss it here. And I'm sure you will understand in one go. You don't need to be wait for anything. It's just a first session, just an introductory session. Just make sure, do not forget the line, two, three lines which I am going to tell you. Everybody in the interview also, they will raise this question. Okay, do you know this, how it works? Let's see this thing first. As I told you, the main.ts file is the entry point of your application. Let me open the main.ts file. Where it is? This one. These are the namespaces as we have in the .NET side. In the Java, we called as an imports for adding the packages. Similarly, in the Angular, we have this packages import. If you wanted to import something or library of a particular thing, if you wanted to include it into your application, we have to use called import. So these are the default libraries which is already added by the Angular. This particular code, it's showing, is telling, are you working with the production environment? Do you want to directly communicate with the prod environment? Yes or no? Based on that, it will enable it. We'll talk about later things when we are trying to deploy it, the application. But the second most important part is, in the Angular, just remember the steps which I'm going to tell you. When the application gets launched, first, compiler will go to the main.ts file. It will check. It will go to the Bootstrap module. Bootstrap module is responsible for to look for a particular module, which module you wanted to load first. By default, it's given a name as app module because we have created this. Because when you have ran that command ng new project name, it has created an app module as the default one. We will be also creating it from our end, from the next sessions also, from next session onwards. But just remember a few things. Whenever once you launch your application, compiler will go to the main.ts file. It will go to the bootstrap module, which it will check which module you wanted to launch first. Okay, I went here, I checked, okay, this is the name as app module. We'll check. I'm placing a cursor here. If you see, it is highlighted in the line number 4. Okay, this is the object I have created. And it, this particular module is coming from dot app folder, app module, app dot module file. See the location it is showing on the top. H drive, Angular training sessions, day 1, session 1, src slash app dot module. So it will go to this particular file. Let's go here. I came here. How I came? Again, I'm going to repeat it here. Going to the main.ts file. First, the compiler will come here. It will check for the bootstrap module, which module you wanted to load first. It will check, okay, I given the app module. I selected it. It came here, line number 4. Okay, this is the app module. It is coming from under app folder. The file name is app.module. If I'm clicking by control key, so it will navigate me to the respective file. Otherwise, you can go manually. So where it is, placing a cursor here, it is showing me day 1, session 1, SRC. Day 1, session 1, SRC. What was the next one? Day 1, session 1, SRC, app. App is the folder. Then app.module, where it is? See, app.module. This is the file. So what will happen? First, compiler will go to the main.ts. Then main.ts, it will look for the bootstrap module, which module you wanted to load. I went to the app module. Then I opened the file. I came here. Now, in the app.module, it will look for bootstrap, which component you wanted to load. Bootstrap means specifying the component for now. Just understand. Bootstrap, which component you wanted to bootstrap it or show it onto the UI. Okay, it is giving a name as an app component. It was created by default. We'll be creating from our end also. So whenever you wanted to add a particular component into the module, first part is you have to declare it. In the declaration section of your @ng module, it's nothing but a metadata. This app module is created on line number 5. We are referring it. We are importing it. This particular component is coming from app.component file. Okay, let's go to the app.component file now. Okay, this is the location app.component. I went to the app.component file. Okay. I'm coming to this one. This is the app component. In this app component, it will look for template URI. Which component you wanted to show? I came to know app.module.component.html. It will go to the app module.component.html. This is the HTML content which we have to create. In simple words, if you ask me how the structure, how this process is going to be work, notepad, let's see. First entry point will be main.ts file. It will check, what it will check? Bootstrap module. Okay, once you will go to the bootstrap module, it will look for what? Look for module, which module you wanted to load. Okay, I got app module, app.module, for example. Then once you Once you go to the app.module.module file, then we will have to check. Let's see app.module we came. How we came here? See, this is also being created now. This session one. Similarly, same code, everything is same. So coming here again, main.ts file, we have it here. This is the bootstrap module. It will look for the app module, which module you wanted to load. Okay, I got this module. I need to load it. I can click on control key and click it here. Automatically it will navigate you, or else you can go it manually. So this is in the .app/app.module. I went to the app.module. Done. Once you reaches here, see app.module, we came here. It came here. App.module. Now it will look for bootstrap, which component you wanted to load. Then that means it will go for look for bootstrap. Bootstrap means, if you see here, which component you wanted to load. Bootstrap nothing but I wanted to specify the component which I wanted to load it. So it looks for the particular component. Okay, so that means I got bootstrap. Look for the bootstrap component name. Okay, I came here. Look for the bootstrap component name. I came here. Then I'm going to move. Okay, this is the component, app component. If I click on here, it will navigate me to this particular class file, the TS file. Once I reach to app component.ts file, it will look for the template URI. In the component, these are the decorators, we'll see later on. This is nothing but the template URI. It means this class is referring to a particular component where you can write your HTML code. So this particular decorator, wherever you will find @sign, we called as decorator. Decorate something for the UI. So this @ component is the decorator where we have these things as a metadata. Inside that, we are looking for template URL or URI. Means this component is associated with which component HTML file. That means, in simple words, I can say, look for the bootstrap component name, then look for actual component file or component HTML. So it came, I came here app component. This is the template URI. If I place a cursor on template URI, or you can directly go to this location, component.html. Okay, I'm going to component.html. This is the place. This is the HTML. If you wanted to run the application, you have to run with ng space serve. ng hyphen serve means if you wanted to launch an application on the browser, you have to run this command. So what it will do, it will compile your code first. Then it will load the application onto the browser. So see, I'm getting some issue here. The serve command requires to be run for in an Angular project, okay? Session one. See, what is the place? Sometimes you will also get the same issue. The serve command requires to be run in the Angular project. My current cursor, here it is. I'm clearing this one. Going again, terminal, new terminal. My current cursor, it is placed in demo session. Demo session is the root one. I have to go into the session one folder. So I'll write cd You can press tab button. It will show the list of folder name. I pressed enter. I came here. Now, this is wherever you will find the node modules. That is the Angular project. Now, if I wanted to run the application, I can write ng serve. That's it. The compiler will compile the Angular application. The beauty of the Angular application, the CLI, whenever you are changing something, and automatically when you press Control S or save, automatically it will refresh your browser. Okay. Why I got this error? Because the reason is being the 4200 is already in use. Why? Let's run this application because this is also running. This is also running. That is why. So I'm running it here only. Okay. Let's see. ng space serve. This is the same application, nothing differences. Because this application was created with the 4200 port. I can also change it dynamically, but for now, just ignore it. It was already running. See, Angular Live Development Server is listening on localhost 4200. Open your browser and you can directly launch it. I already ran it. See, oh, it's already open it. Let's see, it is already running, so I can directly go to which location? HTTP localhost 4200. I am opening the browser here. It is already running. Or I can do one thing. See, it is compiling now. See, 10% building. It is compiling everything. And it will launch the browser for me. If it won't launch, I'll do it from my end. Compiled successfully. Go to the browser. Just type localhost 4200. See, I got this page. Why I am getting this one? Because the reason is being, I'm closing this project now. This is the project because I have this much of code. I'm deleting everything now. Just ignore the last line. We'll discuss later when we start exactly the project development. I'm just writing H1 is the tag. I'm writing here, hello, welcome to session one. Control S. See, wherever you see the white symbol, that means the file is not being saved. I'm pressing Control S. Once you clicked on save, automatically browser is getting to be refreshed. See, automatically I did not refresh it. Wanted to check dynamically, just see here. Now see, I'm pressing, I'm giving a H2 tag. How was the demo? I'm pressing Control S. See, till now, browser is not getting refreshed because it is showing as a white symbol. I'm pressing Control S. See, compile. In. Now, till now, we reached up to app.component.html and it was referenced in the app comp. This one. Let's talk about one more thing. I came to this particular template URI where I can find the HTML. But how this particular component, app.component, is going to be loaded into your HTML? The most important part in Angular is the selector. Index.html is the plain file. If you wanted to load a particular component in the HTML, we have to work on the selector part. Selector, see here, selector, what the name I have given? App-root. This is my selector name for this entire component. If I wanted to show this component onto the index page, what I need to do, I'm going to copy the name, app-root.copy, going to the index.html page. How we can do it, see? I saved it. Index.html does not have anything. Let's see the browser. It is not showing anything. So you created already have the component, component.ts file. There it is referring to the which HTML you wanted to load. This is the selector. If you wanted to load the component onto the index file or any HTML file, copy this particular app-root, whatever the name you have given. It's up to you. You can give anything. I'm copying this name.
You can give any name for selector.
My name. I can give Ashwin. Got it? But still now, okay. It is not showing anything to me. I need to copy this selector. I'm going to copy this selector, going to the index.html page because I wanted to load it. I'll write this one, Ashwin, that's it. And save it. Let's go and check into the browser. Oops, see? It came, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
So what it is, what we understood, the entire flow is this way. First, it will go to the main.ts file. It will look for the bootstrap module. Then it will go for the particular module. Then in the module, it will look for which
component
bootstrap I got. Okay, this is the component. Then it will go and check in the template URI, which component or HTML file you loaded. But this component file, this HTML file will be available on the index.html. Once you specify your selector, this is your selector. Once you copy the selector, add it to the index.html, then it will going to be rendered. Any doubt, any confusion?
No.
No, sir.